Hi ladies, how's everyone doing today? I am not in my usual place. I'm doing this live from my car in a parking lot. I'm just in the midst of running errands, actually post office runs, and I felt compelled to pop in real quick and just share more about this concept of what is a subconscious block? What does that even mean? What does it do? How does it show up? And also just share a little bit more with you ladies, especially to you ladies who read my post yesterday. I received a ton of DMs. Actually, I'm kind of overwhelmed by the amount of kindness and support I received sharing about what I did yesterday. I had never been so real, raw, honest, and vulnerable with my community. I've shared about my 20s, but I haven't gone as far back as childhood. And I think I felt timid to be that transparent with everyone because part of me felt like it's too heavy a story and not very light, and perhaps it would be a downer. And then the other part of me was concerned, well, if I share about everything, perhaps women would think I have a victim mentality, and I want to assure you, I do not have any victim mentality. In fact, I believe I actually, as a soul, selected my family unit to grow up in for a very important reason and directly tied into my purpose. So I think I had some feelings of being timid, of sharing about all of the things, just in case anyone got the wrong impression, because like I said, I definitely don't view myself a victim in any shape or form. Hey, welcome. Hey, Kelly. So happy to have you ladies here. I'm randomly in my car in the parking lot. In any case, so let's talk about it. What is a subconscious block? By the way, this isn't my smartphone. I literally have my laptop and Starbucks is right beside me, so I'm tapping into their Wi-Fi. Okay, so what is a subconscious block? What does that even mean? Where does it come from? How does it show up? How do you know if you have one active in your life? So you can think of a subconscious block as a pattern that, or even a belief system, something that's imprinted into our unconscious mind. That's why we're not consciously aware of it. With how the world we know, at least from our vantage point, operates. And this is typically imprinted, the ones that we carry with us and have recurring problems show up in our adult years, they're typically imprinted in childhood. And they can even be imprinted, believe it or not, in utero when we're in our mother's womb, depending on what's going on in her life, in her own emotional state. So it's quite fascinating the more you dive into this. So that says each one of us is going to have a different kind of roadblock or subconscious block to show up in our life, depending on where that block resides or how it was imprinted. For a lot of people, I know myself especially, it was the relationship category. But for others, it might be more to do with self-confidence or belief in themselves to go for their dreams, whatever the case. Everyone has a different one because even if you grow up with, all of the advantages you could dream of, like on a silver spoon kind of thing, it doesn't mean you won't have some sort of pattern, because it could be something as minute as being made fun of on the playground that could stick with you and affect your confidence later in life. So it doesn't actually have to be as traumatic as my abusive upbringing. So one example of, okay, do I have a subconscious block that could be active in my life? Like, how do I know? Would be, do you have the same kind of relationship pattern showing up with men? A real telltale sign is if you're left with a similar feeling experience at the end of different relationships, even though it's with a different partner, you're still left feeling the same kind of way or wanting things to be this certain way that it still doesn't seem to be happening. Another sign that there could be a block is if you're feeling on an ongoing basis underappreciated by people, whether it be your boss, your coworkers, your partner, your spouse, but there's this feeling of not being fully seen for who you are. Another example could be on the financial side of things. So perhaps less money rolling in or struggling to make ends meet every month, having like the same amount, just enough to cover your bills. Okay, that's another example. And a really common one, especially with women I've worked with, would be just simply having less confidence and clarity in oneself and the direction one is heading. Perhaps trusting your intuition less than other people. maybe getting close to success, but then something swooping in and feeling like it's stopping it just before. Maybe it's more impactful to your lifestyle or the kinds of clients or customers you're attracting to you. That can be a big part of boundaries. And another common theme would be seeing other women or men blast off to success and you're just feeling left like you're in slow-mo or quicksand or just something isn't moving fast enough. So again, depending on where the block resides, we can each have a different way it seems to be showing up. But the key thing is noticing the pattern, right? Different situations, but same feeling experience you're being left with. So as I said, where do they come from? It doesn't actually have to be traumatic. An example could be maybe you were in grade 2 and it was your chance to speak up at the front of the class and you forgot what to say or people laughed at you. That could have created an unconscious belief that says, I'm not safe to be visible and share my message with the world. Because maybe right now you do need to be visible and share your message with the world to do what you want to do for work, but you have this hidden incentive of not speaking up, which means preventing yourself from being made fun of or feeling foolish, right? Another example could be maybe you were left on an ongoing basis feeling like you weren't enough, like you weren't meeting the cut to your teacher's expectations or your parents' expectations, or maybe they treated a sibling different than you, but there's something about that it feels like you're never meeting the cut and you're never enough, right? And that can definitely show up with the things we manifest in adult life. Another example could be maybe you have a crush on a boy and he doesn't like you, but he likes your friend, right? Without consciously becoming aware of it, you could have an imprint that says you're not safe or being in your partnership, something doesn't feel safe when he's around other women. Like you could have trust issues or jealousy issues, right? So the list goes on and on and on. The example I shared, if you saw yesterday's post, was actually about my subconscious imprint, my key one. It's called the mother wound, about being neglected and abandoned growing up. Cole's Notes version is I had a really dysfunctional home and my parents weren't able to take care of me and my mom moved away when I was 12 and I lived with my dad until I was 15 and he was quite psychologically abusive and also physically abusive and I was removed from his home at 15 and put in with another family. And they treated me lovely and well and all the good things, all the normal things. And then I moved out on my own right after I graduated high school. And I was so motivated to get my life together and be successful and break free from those situations I was afflicted with as a child. You can check yesterday's post to see what that was all about. But in any case, it's interesting because even though I was so gung-ho and on a mission to be successful, I didn't realize it, but I was actually unconsciously drawing in the exact same kinds of relationships with men throughout my 20s that I experienced with my father in terms of the feeling I was always left when dating them, or in one scenario, actually marrying someone and getting divorced in my late 20s. And it was always being left with the feeling of being neglected, not cared about, not seen, not important, not of value, lied to, cheated on, disrespected, put down, all the things, like very narcissistic behaviors, which is common for an empath to actually draw in their earlier life as part of their spiritual evolution to get on with their light work or purpose. But in any case, I sat down and I had to really ask myself when I got divorced at 29 and was really going through the dark night of the soul, well, what is the common denominator in all of these challenges showing up in my life? And how come no matter how much I desire a healthy, loving, caring, nurturing relationship, how come I keep attracting what seems to be like very, very mean men or emotionally unavailable men, unloving men into my life? That was the question. It really didn't make sense. My friends had these relationships. Why didn't I? And in my soul searching and journey into self-development and self-love and really like uncovering who I am and why I'm here, I eventually went down the rabbit hole with healing my life and learning about my own subconscious imprints, what they were, how they developed, and most importantly, how to heal them, how to dissolve them so that the pattern didn't continue to show up. And the interesting thing with this is that so many women feel like they want to, like, it's almost like gambling or like a like who gets lucky, like winning the lottery, just hoping like the next person they attract treats them right. When it doesn't work that way, the shift on healing the block actually is an internal shift in terms of dissolving that unconscious pattern. There's a vibrational shift that also has to take place so that we stop attracting mirrors in our 3D reality that show us what part of ourselves hasn't been fully seen, witnessed, honored, healed, and then dissolved. Because it's like if you brush the dirt under the table or under the carpet, you might not see it, but it's still there. And so with the power of healing the subconscious block is you're not just sweeping it under the table anymore. You're actually seeing it, bringing it forth, illuminating it, and then taking actual tangible steps to dissolve it, right? And that's one reason I'm popping in this live today is because I want to explain more about the power of this 3-week mini course that's available as of tomorrow. I've never offered a 3-week course before. Most of you ladies, if you've done any of my programs, you know they're 3 to 4 months long, sometimes even longer. I don't want to give the impression just because it's 3 weeks, it doesn't have immense value, because I'm getting laser sharp into really supporting the women who go through the 3-week course. It has 3 different lessons, one delivered each week, with different emails, different videos, and different workbooks that are actually going to guide you through a process to help illuminate crystal clarity. Well, what is that mother wound? Doesn't mean it's from your mother. It just means it was imprinted earlier in life. How did it show up? Why did it show up? Where does it show up now? And how is it blocking you from moving forward on what you actually desire? Whether it be in relationship, career, finances, your purpose, how you feel about yourself, you name it. How to also uncover hidden incentives that might be active, keeping you stuck where you are versus where you actually want to go. And a really powerful part of the course is actually making peace with your pain. So not just looking at, okay, this happened and now I'm carrying on this pattern, oh, woe is me, but really taking this empowered stance of, okay, I see why that happened and I see how I can actually transmute this, make peace with this, and move on forward, onward, and upward in my life in a more successful, empowered, on fire way than I've ever been before. And dare I say it, even look at that subconscious imprint and the journey to healing it as part of how you yourself could be of service in your own mission, how you yourself could support other people, men, women, children, who knows, one day move through what you're going to be growing through yourself. And subconscious blocks, they don't heal overnight. It's a gradual process, but awareness is key. Awareness is number one. It's illuminating it, seeing it, and then understanding what new action is specifically required to limit and then eventually stop altogether that pattern. And the pattern is having the universe show us mirrors. And then when that pattern changes, we're shown mirrors to a different reality, a different experience. That's when we actually are able to access a new paradigm. A paradigm is the life we operate in based on our thoughts, feelings, beliefs, our perceptions, our consciousness, and our subconsciousness. There's so many layers to it, but it's extremely dramatic, the shift that we can experience when we shatter the old paradigm, the subconscious imprints, that glass ceiling to that next level of success that is lurking there, but we can't really see it, but we know that there's something not allowing, right? And the other part of the 21-day mini course is in the final module, you get an action plan to actually support you not only in the month ahead, not only 6 months ahead, but the next 12-month cycle of your life, taking into account your subconscious imprint, your core desired feelings, how you really want to feel and experience your life, your ideal lifestyle, your ideal income, your ideal health and fitness, your ideal sense of purpose and contribution, how you show up in the world. So it's really a beautiful way to kickstart 2020 on the right foot, let go of the old stories, old patterns, old limitations that may have served you at one point in time, that may have protected you or kept you playing safe in this past decade. But ladies, we're stepping forward. It's the age of Aquarius. It's 2020. It's time to let go of that dead weight, of that old baggage, and step into our power. And I'm talking about myself included, right? I'm not invincible to these subconscious blocks. Lord knows I've been through them, but God knows my life is so much different now. And I do believe it's part of my mission. And one reason I was even inflicted with what I was is so that I could be a teacher on this topic, because it means so much to me and it's near and dear to my heart. And I would love to be of service for you ladies in this unique way as well. So if that sounds good to you, I'm going to drop a link to the product info page in the comments. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. You can email me or the team. You can DM me as well, and I'll be glad to answer. The ladies who've already purchased, check your emails tomorrow. At some point, they're going to be coming in, and it's going to be shared with you over the next 3 weeks so that you can really feel on fire, unstoppable, a fucking force of nature this next year ahead. I'm cheering you on, and I really believe in each and every one of you. I hope you guys have a beautiful day, and we'll talk soon.